Hello students, this is Abhijit Shah from SNCS. Today we will discuss about one history topic, the later Vedic period. Okay, already you learn about early Vedic period, so the next chapter is later Vedic period. Okay, so first one is Aryabhatta, a later Vedic period. By about 1500 BCE, the Aryans came into the Indian subcontinent from Central Asia and settled in the Saptasindhu region. So at first they settled in the Saptasindhu region and known as Brahmavarta. And this period is called the early Vedic period. We already learned about it. And around 1000 BCE, the Aryans left Brahmavarta and moved eastwards and southward into the Ganga Valley, clearing the thick forest as they went along. And the period between 1000 BC and 600 BC marks the later Vedic period. So this time that from 1000 to 600 BC, this time is called as later Vedic period, when the Aryans settled in Aryabhatta. The composition of the three later Vedas, Samveda, Yajurveda and Atharva Veda, along with the Brahmanas, Aranyaks and Upanishads of all four Vedas happened during this period. The epic Ramayana and Mahabharata were also composed during this period. Okay, and the highlight of the later Vedic period was the emergence of agriculture on a large scale and transition of the Aryans from nomadic to settled life. So in that time, what happened? They emerged their agricultural activity on a large scale, and they also settled in a selected place. They lived the nomadic life and they settled in a certain place. And there was widespread use of iron, which revolutionized agriculture. And iron plowshares were increasingly used in agriculture. They used various kind of iron tools for their agricultural activity. And this meant that heavy clay soil could be turned over better than with a wooden plowshare. And excavations near the Ganga plain, the three later Vedas and the epics provided information on the political, social and economic life of the Aryans in the later Vedic period. Okay, and political structure. What was the political structure of the time? That while in the early Vedic period, kings ruled over the small tribes or clans, in the later Vedic period, these tribes expanded to form a large kingdom. So in the time of later Vedic period, the small tribal peoples, they expanded. And they made the large kingdoms. And the earliest Aryan kingdoms were Kuru, Panchala, Kosala, Magadha and Kashi. The formation of large kingdoms increased the power of the chief or king. Kingship became hereditary and tribal assemblies like the Sabha and Samiti lost their importance. So when the tribal people, they made their government, they made their all kinds of rules, regulations, that in that time, the Sabha and Samiti, they lost their power. And the king's influence was strengthened by rituals, and he performed the Rajasura sacrifice, and which was supposed to confer supreme power on him. And the Ashwamedha or the horse sacrifice was also performed to establish the king's undisputed authority over the areas the horse moved unchallenged. So in that time also the system was there, the Ashwamedha Yagya, and it is that the capturing of the land with the help of horse. This also done in that time. Next is social life, class structure. The occupational division of society of the early Vedic period became more rigid and hereditary in the later Vedic period. And social classes were now known as caste varna. They were known as varna and decided by birth, not by their occupation. Okay, the four main varnas were the Brahmins or the priest class, Kshatriya means the ruling or warrior class, Vaishya or the traders, merchants and peasants and artisans, they are under Vaishyas, and the Shudras, they are the lower class immersed in menial work. And the caste system became so rigid that people were not allowed to change their caste or occupation. So this is hereditary in nature. They cannot change their occupation. They cannot shift it from one class to one another class. Brahmanas and Kshatriyas enjoyed privileges denied to Vaishya and Shudras. And inter-caste marriage were strictly prohibited, as the high caste people looked down upon the low caste people. Four ashramas. Towards the later Vedic period, the life of an individual was divided into four stages or ashramas. There was the tradition of four ashramas, and each stage indicates the journey of man according to Vedic tradition. The first one is the Brahmacharya Ashrama or the student life was the first stage of man's life. First, student life was known as Brahmacharya, and in this stage he received education from the guru, from his guru and or teacher in a gurukul. So the tradition was that students need to go into the house of guru, and there they need to take the teaching. Grihastha Ashrama or life as a householder is the stage where the man gets married and perform his duties as a son, husband and father. And during this stage, he works to earn a living for his family using the skills he learned in Gurukul. They express all the activities what he learned in Gurukul. Next was Vanaprastha Ashrama or the life as a hermit is the stage where the man, after completing his worldly duties and hand the household responsibilities to his successor, and leaves the worldly life, and he goes to the forest and leads a life of meditation and solitude. Next is Sannyasa Ashrama or a life as a sadhu is the last stage, and where the man renounces all the comforts of life, becomes spiritual and leads the life of an ascetic focusing on moksha. And Gurukul system of education. So there was the system of education as Gurukul, and Gurukul system of education was prevalent during the Vedic period, and boys and youngs as 7 to 8 years were sent to a Gurukul, and where they lived with their guru till the age of up to 25 years. And the guru imparted knowledge on various subjects. The Shishyas or the students were also taught household chores, and life in the Gurukul was very simple, and the students looked upon the guru as their spiritual father. They believed that the guru is the spiritual father, and after their education was over, the Shishyas paid the guru Dakshina or fees. There was a system of Guru Dakshina, or after the complete of the learning, they give some things as a Guru Dakshina. And family life, the family was the basic unit of Vedic society, and the power of the father increased during the later Vedic period. And when compared to early Vedic period, the status of women declined, and they no longer participate in the public affairs. We already learned in the early Vedic period that there was the respect of women, but this is declining in nature in the later Vedic period. Next is religion, that in the later Vedic period, Brahma, the creator, Vishnu, the preserver, and the Shiva, the destroyer, gained prominence over early Vedic duties such as Varuna, Indra, and Agni. So there was the popularity of Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. And worship included elaborate rituals and sacrifices performed only by Brahmanas. And this led to a rise in the social status of the Brahmanas. Towards the end of the Vedic period, Upanishads were compiled. And in the end of the later Vedic period, in that time, Upanishads also compiled. Economic life of later Vedic period, occupation. The Aryans in the later Vedic age had made great economic progress. In that time, they do various economic progresses, and agriculture became the primary occupation of the people, and focus on agriculture meant that land became more important than cattle. So they focus on the agriculture, then they realize that land became more important than cattle rearing, that land agriculture activity is more important than the cattle rearing. And the Aryans used iron to improve agriculture techniques, and they use also various kind of iron tools for improving the agricultural activity. And apart from agriculture, people were also engaged in spinning, weaving, carpentry, hunting, metalwork, and pottery. Next is trade. Both internal and foreign trade progressed, and currency started being used, and we have reference to Krishnala, a tiny seed-sized metal object used as a weight, and Nishaka or Shatamanas were medium of exchange, and cities like Hastinapur, Kashi, Bidheya emerged as trade center. This place was placed as a trade center. Okay, next is pottery. That later Vedic period were acquainted with four types of pottery, that black and red ware, black shipped ware, painted grey ware, and red ware. They was habituated with these kinds of pottery system, and red ware was the most popular and is founded almost over the western UP. And however, the pottery that characterized this period is painted grey ware, PGW, and glass words and bangles have been found along with PGW. PGW has been recovered from western UP, Delhi, Punjab, and Haryana. Okay, So the comparison in between the later Vedic period and early Vedic period, this is the comparison in between these two. That location, Saptasindhu region, this also Ganga Valley, this is Ganga Valley, Aryabhatta, and it is known as Brahmavarta. Time period is from 1500 BC to 1000 BC. This is 1000 BC to 6000 BC. Source of information, we can got the information regarding the early Vedic period from the Rig Veda, and we learned about the later Vedic period from Samveda, Atharva Veda, and Yajur Veda, and this kinds of things. Political structure, that chief ruled over tribes or clans, and their large kingdoms ruled by kings. Power and authority, social stratification, position of women, that respectable position of women, but this in that time, later Vedic period, that the position of women is deteriorated. Religion, and this religion, that they worshipped of Indra, Agni, Surya in the time of early Vedic period, and after that Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar was the chief gods.